so many different groups of young people like them in the background telling their stories. But the main challenge has been, where is the money for their hard work?
Aya Gloria is an actress and a makeup artist based in Gulu City. She is among the many creative people in the city who have recently flocked to the filmmaking industry.
We do create our contents, which are interesting, but we can't submit them in those national TVs. Why? Because you see them, they ask, we want contents with Luganda and what? And English. And you find out that this is a Luo-based area. We can't make our contents only in English.
Her complaint has been that locally produced content does not sell nationally due to a language barrier. While at Gulu Film Production, Daniel Komakech believes that a lack of a paying platform has affected the creative industry in the region.
The biggest challenge that we have now is a platform that helps creatives to sell their work instantly and get money.
Daniel Komakech is a renowned movie director in Gulu, with titles such as A Girl from Lamu. He also won a national award for the 2014 Best Short Film, Crying for Help. The pain of the filmmakers is equally felt by the musicians and comedians, as there is no money for their creative works.
We spend a lot of money in production, and then later after the production is done, their music is normally put out on the street, whereby it is a different people gaining from their music, from their craft. So as Mali UG, we have come up with a platform that would enable the artist to be a first-hand consumer of their, like the money coming out of their art.
In countries like Nigeria, India and the United States of America, the creative industry is credited for its major contribution to the economic development of their nations. In Uganda, the National Culture Forum sees the industry as a stepping stone to the maintenance of our diverse cultures.
Actors and actresses to behave Uganda, to portray Uganda, because this app goes beyond Uganda borders. So those people, those whites, they're also interested in studying how is Uganda culture portrayed. So we shouldn't be copycatting the Western cultures. We do our thing, what we understand.
And in today's dot-com era, filmmakers, musicians, comedians, and other creatives are being encouraged to embrace the emerging digital platforms such as YoTV, Malo UG, among others.
So even if you're in a rural area and only one person has a smartphone, that person is going to be some kind of source of pride to people that don't have this smartphone. If they know that this person uses this smartphone to watch a movie, this person has the OTV channels app, they don't need an actual TV.
When the producer gets money, they will have to get a new project, they will have to create a new project, and they work on a new project. There is when we actors and directors come in, because they will be hiring us to do their job.
Aya Gloria is among the 50 creatives who today attended a meeting on how to make real money from their art. The meeting held at Tax Art Center was conducted by the YoTV team in order to awaken the creative industry in northern Uganda.
These platforms are designed to make some money for creatives and content creators before they actually go to stage, before they go to stage, or they actually make the money that will take them to set or to stage.
When supported, it is highly believed that the creative industry, especially film, can be a source of employment to the country's redundant young population. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.